So I want to do another video as a follow-up to why I hate shorting. Now, here's the thing. With GameStop going up, you know, over 200-300% in a few weeks, it's gone from like two-something dollars a share. You know, if you look at the 52-week low to the high, it's gone from, you know, two-something a share to about $70 a share. It's a little ridiculous. Now, here's the thing to get. Wall Street Bets, that Reddit, you know, that Reddit forum, very powerful in terms of being able to move the market, especially when you're dealing with smaller, more liquid kinds of securities. I mean, God forbid GameStop had more shares short than shares outstanding. Not super liquid. I mean, it's somewhat liquid, but not super liquid. So here you have a small company, not, you know, not the kind of liquidity of a Coca-Cola or a Google, and you have more shares short than shares outstanding. All Wall Street Bets needs to do is figure out that's not going to be our target for this week. Massive short squeeze. If that was 1% of your book and you don't cover, game over. You're screwed. You know, the game of investing, part of the success is literally just being able to stay in the game. If you do average and stay in the game, you do significantly better than average of, you know, the average investor that only captures about 20% of the market returns. So if you lose, you know, if you go belly up, if your fund goes to zero or negative, you don't get the opportunity to keep playing that game. So this is why I hate shorting and why I especially hate shorting in this kind of market. I think you got to be a total moron to be doing massive short selling in this kind of market. Those are my thoughts.